Shalom. I'm Kahan Tazadok, one who was sent by the Most High Yahuwah to give you this right knowledge and to fight this war on aphasia. We form a single united body. We are family. The enemy was split into portions and disguised themselves to try to infiltrate the truth, because the devil is a liar and will attempt to sabotage our family with lies and deceit. Join Yochanan 9:31, and you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free. People need the truth. More than anything, our people need the truth. Why? Because of Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Therefore, the most valuable thing that I, Kahan Tazadok, has been sent to give you, my family, is the truth. But they suffer from aphasia, so it won't be easy. They are the Lord's sheep that's mentioned in Yochanan, John 10:16. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So they will be one flock, one shepherd. This fold has no room for snitches, brothers and sisters. This fold has no room for beta simp manginas. When the enemy comes, their attack will be numerical. Numerical weakness comes from having to prepare against possible attacks. Numerical strengths from the compelling our adversaries to make these preparations against us. And you should know the truth, and the truth will make you free. I'm Kahan Tazadok, secure creditor, secure party, and I would like to teach you to become a member of this family, a member of this fold. But you must be an advocate for truth. And if you're not willing to die for this truth, for the freedom, the liberation, and justice for our family, then don't come towards this truth. Stay away from the truth, because you're part of the lie. But if you are a true devout and you are a freedom fighter for the truth, because the enemy that we're warring against is spiritual. This is an ideological spiritual war. And if you would like to be a member of this body, of this fold, of this family, then contact Kahan Tazadok. Become a secure party creditor now. There's no one out there, no one on the internet, no one anywhere in the world that could give you this as Kahan Tazadok, because it was given to him by the Most High. Hallelujah. So my question to you is, are you ready for this truth? With principles that we live by, it's called the TDOY. TDOY is an acronym for the true disciples of Yahusha, Yahweh Shai. We have a commando's creed. Commando is C-O-M-M-A-N-D-O. Every letter has a representation. The C in commando is for cardinal. Cardinal, that I place the Most High first, and that I acknowledge that I am my brother's keeper. I love my brothers as I love myself. Remember that I volunteered as a commando, fully aware of the hazards of my choice of being a soldier in the army of Yahusha, Yahweh Shai. I will always endeavor to uphold the prestige, honor, and spirit decor of TDOY, the true disciples of Yahusha, Yahweh Shai. Commandos, memorize Yochanan, John and 31. The O is for order. It's the proper way in which all things must be done. The scriptures say in 1 Corinthians 14, verse 40, let all things be done decently and in order. The order is Yahweh, Yahuwah, the Father, Yahusha, Yahweh Shai, the Son, and man, then woman, then children. Without proper order, there's chaos. The M is for muse. Muse over each situation prior to acting emotionally. Be slow to anger, as it says in the book of James 1 and 19. People with understanding control their anger. A hot temper shows great foolishness and folly. With patience comes great understanding. Onward will I display the intentional fortitude required to fight on to the commando's objective and complete the mission, though I be the lone survivor. That's how we want it. The second M is for master. Master your skills. We live in a world where we want instant solutions and gratification and the least amount of effort on our part. The TDOY commando must be a master of his craft, or her craft, and art. He cannot be a solution. It's not tangible. To master my skills requires time to develop skills and learn techniques. This is the root of my success, a mindset that enables me to manage my time effortlessly to master my skills. The A is for occur. Occur knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the scriptures and of my craft and my fighting skills, mentally, spiritually, and physically. I must never forget that we the commandos are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, 1 Peter 2 and 9, that we should show forth the praises of him who have called us out of darkness into the marvelous light, HaMashiach, Yahusha. The end is for never. Never shall I fail my Akim. Akim is a Paleo-Hebrew word for brothers. I will always keep myself mentally alert, physically strong, and morally straight. And I will shoulder more than my share of the task. Whatever it may be, absolute devotion 100% and beyond. The D is for demolish my enemies and foes. I will show the world that I am specially selected and well-trained commando in accordance with 2 Samuel 23, verse 8 through 28. My courtesy to the Most High, the laws, statutes, and commandments, neatness of dress, and care of equipment will set the example for others to follow. The O is for onward. Onward will I fight in my defense, in the defense of my family. We're family. TDOY, a family. Repeat after me. We're family. TDOY, a family. In my Akim, meaning brothers. I will face the enemies of my nation. I will defeat them on the field of battle. For I am better trained, and I will fight with all my might, and my spirit of Adonai is upon me. Surrender is not a commando start. We're not allowed to use such words. I will never leave a fallen Akim, brother or sister, to fall in the hands of the enemy, and under no circumstances will I ever embarrass my nation. Yasha Allah. We're unlike others. We're unlike other camps. We are the true disciples of Yahusha. TDOY. and this is the Commando's Creed. I am Kahan Tazadok. If you would like to become a commando and fight this war on a phaser and become a member of the family without any polemics, then contact Kahan Tazadok.
Shalom, my shalom ha, my shalom me, and to the Moors, Islam, and to everyone else, hi. Are you being hung with student loans, credit card debts, foreclosures, child support, DWIs, traffic stops, whatever else? If you are, you really need to listen up. Become a secure party creditor now. What is a secure party creditor? A secure party creditor, SPC, is a term that is actually being used and becoming more popular among those over the internet. More importantly, among those seeking to be true adepts within common law student arena. Many people are trying to obtain higher levels of freedom, reserving their inalienable rights, and have discovered the secured party creditor status, yet they do not truly comprehend what it means. So most scammers over the internet cannot properly articulate exactly what a secured party creditor is. So I'm often asked the question, what is a secured party creditor? Well, essentially, it is actually separating you, the living soul, the man or the woman, from the debtor straw man, which is the all capital letters name, the trademark name that is actually on your birth certificate, which is the legal name, and essentially protecting the assets and collateral of the name by backdating a security agreement, that's a security agreement, to your age of majority. So this essentially alters your status from that of a debtor straw man fiction to a secured party creditor or a lien holder over the name and the said property of the name, which is a corporation, therefore protecting its assets from lien, levy, seizures, grace garnishments, and forfeiture. So if you're listening to me now, you may be having your wages garnished or your property may have actually been levied, and then it's eventually sold. See, as a secured party creditor, I am exempted from such things. So now, because of fraud, the legal name, deceit, that you were actually not aware until now, you heard it on YouTube, but it was never quite explained this way. Now, be honest. See, you now are protected once you become a secured party creditor against the fraud by voiding all previous contracts if the party being defrauded takes affirmative action to call out the fraud. Now you have, in effect, canceled out the disastrous effects of those contracts in your life that were actually done without your consent or your best interest in mind. So now, that sounds far-fetched because you've been actually living within the matrix of deceit. But as you keep listening to me, Tazadok Shaw, the Undaunted National on a YouTube channel, also the Deprogrammed Enlightener on a YouTube channel, and visiting my website at www.truedisciplesofchrist.org and join, you would actually get over 1,000 hours of free downloadable video lessons. Now, I'm sure you would get to a point of understanding this information much better. See, we all see how higher levels of fraud, corruption, taking place every day. Some of you always knew that something was wrong, but you didn't know exactly what. So, bringing the growth number of people that essentially are learning about the secured party creditor filing press to new heights. So, it is important, family, to totally comprehend, to understand, to understand that becoming a secured party creditor does not mean that you just file a UCC-1, as many of the scammers falsely teach over the internet. That's the lie that's actually promoted. You must be very hard-pressed. You must be devoted and a mature and your studies. You must be very mature in your studies, as you will be tested again and again in your journey towards becoming a secured party creditor. Many of these public servants that you refer to as politicians, judges, lawyers, they have plausible liability, and having such, they would deny that it actually exists. So you will be tested, so you must know what you're alleging that you know. See, the same agencies that are actually feeling threatened are also much aware that most people doing the so-called secure party creditor filing does not understand what they're actually doing. And the scammers that are actually giving them this information don't understand either. So if they do understand, they understand very little about the correct process of establishing a secured party creditor status, which is why you should come to Taza Doc Shaw Day, the Undaunted National Deprogram Enlightener. Subscribe now and join our website. So the status and maintaining that status, you have to know that you're secure in your status and how to maintain that status, and living as both a private citizen and the trustee of a domestic public trust vessel that contracts and operates in the public and in commerce. So become a secure party creditor over the debtor strongman is what you need to do. We must first understand that we all function through our debtor, which is a strongman, which is a corporation, also known as a trade name, which is a business name and will become your business name. And you, as the living soul, function in commerce through the strongman, which is the corporation again. However, you are not the strongman. I cannot overemphasize that. This is one of the main purposes of establishing ourselves as a secured party creditor. We must create a separation between the live living soul and the corporation, which is a strongman, which is a trade name, which is a debtor. Another purpose of the secure party creditor filing is to aid in the protection of all assets held in the estate, which is held by your corporation, which is a strongman, which is a trade name, which is the legal fiction, which is a corporate construct. It is actually often referred to by many terms, all meaning one and the same. So the estate encompasses everything from property to your bank accounts, etc., etc. Now that we've actually established what the strongman corporation is, the legal fiction, the legal name, we must establish what exactly Taza Doc is a secured party creditor. Now, what is that? What is a secured party creditor? It's how one would actually use a UCC filing, which actually places a financial lien against the property of the debtor. So a secured party creditor essentially is one who holds an interest in a company's assets. Your company being your corporation, which is a strongman. They would actually record this interest in the public record first by filing a UCC-1 financial statement. So if the strongman, which is the corporation, is a business, and we, as the living souls, hold an interest in that estate of the corporation, we must file a UCC-1 financial statement to give notice to the public that we have a lien on all property pertaining to that corporation, which is the strongman, which is the trade name. It is important to remember that UCC-1 itself is not the lien. I cannot overemphasize that. It is only notice of the lien. The lien itself is established by the security agreement between the secured party and the debtor strongman corporation. There, no one's actually ever explained that to you. I know, because most people on the web are not teaching you the truth about this. Most of them are charlatans. So the security agreement is a private agreement which specifies that the debtor, the strongman, the legal name, must perform as the transmitting utility for the secured party creditor in commerce. in exchange for the secured party creditor providing asset and collateral to the debtor strongman, which is the corporation. This would be called equal consideration. So this agreement would also specify the sum of typically $100 billion as a security interest from the corporation, which is the debtor, which is the strongman, to I, the living soul, the secured party creditor. So the security interest amount doesn't have to be $1 billion, but it should be a high enough number to ensure that the secured party will always have the paramount claim of entrance over all assets and property of the debtor or the corporation. Do you understand? Do you understand? So, to help you understand more and overstand more, look up secured party creditor definition and other related terms in a Black Lewis dictionary, preferably the fourth edition or earlier. So, the filing of the UCC-1 is also important because it gives notice to all agencies, which means that no agency can compel the strongman, the debtor, to turn over any assets before first meeting its $1 billion bond obligation to the secured party creditor. First in line, first in time. That's a maxim of law. This is how all assets of the trade name can be protected by the proper use of the secured party creditor process. Now, I'm giving you right knowledge. This is what I give. There's other people that do this stuff for you. They don't give you the understanding, so you do not know how to handle a simple commercial presentment. But what I give you, right knowledge. This is God's word. This is all spiritual. However, it is important to remember that the de facto, a government and its agencies can change their policies constantly, which potentially change the way we achieve our remedies. Remember that. Therefore, we must not be attached to the secure party creditor filing as the only way to achieve freedom. You got to get my books. You can get them on my website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. My book, The Infliction of Commerce, Commercial Warfare, Second Edition, Red Pill, Right Knowledge, and The Corporation versus We the People. Also, The Real Hebrew Israelites versus Edom and Khazaria, and a new and upcoming book that I have not put out yet. So, this process may actually and should evolve as the policies governing commercial business. You understand? So, even though agencies can change their policies at any time, whereby the change or manner of achieving our remedy, they can never actually take away our remedy. Remember? So, there must always be a form to achieve our remedy. So, we just have to continue to do our due diligence, family, and learn to roll with the punches. So, protecting our assets is not the only thing that is actually accomplished through the secure party creditor process. Many of you ask me, Tazadot, what is the benefit of becoming a secure party creditor? Well, here it is again. So, we can also do what is referred to as securing our assets that are actually being held by the financial institutions and governmental agencies, such as loans, bonds, or tickets. So whenever we sign for something, such as when we sign a promissory note for a mortgage, what happens is that the banking institutions hold on to that asset, which actually rightfully belongs to us, and give us the liability side of the transaction. Most people are not aware of that, which is the obligation to pay. So with the secure party creditor filing, we are placing ourselves in a position where we can actually either redeem our asset to close out that account. This is why they do not want you to become a secure party creditor, and why I'm always saying, become a secure party creditor now. I'm pulling my hair out. What are you waiting for? So, or we could actually discharge the alleged debt to close out the account in accordance with House Joint Resolution 192 and Public Law 7310. We have actually our remedy to either redeem our assets or discharge the alleged debt. But we must first have the correct status established in commerce. Since only secured party creditors can operate on the credit side of any transaction, you have to become a secured party creditor. I cannot overemphasize it. Debtors can only operate on the liability side and must pay their obligations. So I have people tell the doc, can a debtor, if you're not a secure party creditor, can you release people from confinement? The answer to that is no. La'ah. In English, no. So you must be a secure party creditor because, again, debtors can only operate on the liability side and must pay their obligations. So by what authority does one have to establish oneself as a secure party creditor of a corporation, of a straw man, of a legal fiction? Well, in commerce, it is the one who provides the funding of a corporation that requires a lien right against all assets of that corporation. So in other words, in layman's term, when a baby has a birth certificate issued against their flesh and body, the corporation is then created. But it is the child that in their lifetime will provide all of their energy, the funding for that particular corporation. Therefore, that child can eventually establish themselves as a secured party creditor for the debtor, the corporation, the legal fiction, the trade name, and thereby secure all assets and collateral pertaining to the trade name. So when the certificate of live birth is issued, it is done without any face value, similar to a blank check. So you know it has value, right? You just don't identify the value until it's time to close out an account. So we do this by sending an identity bond for educational purposes only, in accordance with House Joint Resolution 192 and Public Law 7310, along with our acceptance of government's order in 1933 under FDR to remove all money of substance and provide our credit to the order to the Treasury to be held in trust for the value of $1 billion or whatever the bond you feel it should be. This bond is used to discharge our public debts on the public side, not on the private side. So there you must understand the difference between public and private. Go and watch my video on YouTube on the Deprogram Enlightenment channel. All of this is done in accordance with the Uniform Commercial Code provision. It is important to have a fundamentally accurate process for ease of enforcement. This process includes the security agreement, the UCC filing, the chargeback, among other things, the common law copyright. Hey, visit our site, get it done. It is important to remember that this is a simple outline of some of the components of a secure party creditor. If you're interested, visit the site now, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org/shop. Become a secure party creditor today. What are you waiting for? You must do your own research to ensure your process is complete before moving forward with discharging debts and redeeming your assets. Do you understand? Do you understand? Well, I'm glad that you do. Roger that. So, secure party creditor status also makes you an American national or a state national under a republic jurisdiction. Contact us now at TazadakShah, TazadakShah, at yahoo.com or 347-618-1783. 347-618-1783, or visit our website www.truedisciplesofchrist.org and get in touch with us and change your life. Check out our products page on the shop page when you visit our website www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. And that's going to do it for this session, ladies and gents. You have been actually under the sounds of the voice of Kahan Tazadok. Tazadok Shah Bey, the Undaunted National on YouTube. The Deprogramming Lightner is another channel that I have on YouTube. And Universal Indigenous TV 7 on YouTube. Tazadok. Like, share, subscribe to all of those channels. Become a secure party creditor now. What are you waiting for? Change your status. Change your life. And with that, I say, Shalom from Yasha'awa. It's long to know.